In this lesson, we're going to explore the authentication options in AWS and also multi-factor authentication, or MFA. So we have a user account here called John. Now, John wants to log into AWS. He does so through using his username and a password and potentially an MFA token, which we'll talk about more just in a moment. Once he's then authenticated, he can then get access to the management console and perform operations in the console. Now, the other methods of accessing AWS are the CLI and the API, and the SDK, which also leverages the API. When you access AWS by one of these methods, you use something called an access key ID and a secret access key. Now, they look like these codes here, so they're a bit more ugly, not as user-friendly as a username and password. But these are then used in your code to authenticate to AWS and through to the API so that you can do whatever you want to do in AWS. These are known as access keys and they're used for programmatic access. We'll create some access keys a bit later on in the course and see how we can use them. Now, the other thing I wanted to talk about here is multi-factor authentication, or MFA. In IT security, we often talk about having different factors of authentication, and authentication is just proving who you are. So a way that you can do that is through something you know, and something you know is a password. If you log in to any kind of IT service using a username and password, the username is something which multiple people might know, but the password is something that you alone should know. So that's the secret, and that's the thing that proves that you are who you say you are. Another factor of authentication is something you have. In this case, you have a physical device like a token or a device that generates a code, and only you can know that code and only because you have in your possession that physical device. Lastly, there's something you are. This is biometrics like fingerprints or retina scans. And we don't use these in AWS, but we do use the first two. And that's why we have multiple factors of authentication. So in AWS, we use something you know, your IAM user account and a password, and then something you have. And that's either a virtual MFA device, such as Google Authenticator on your mobile phone, or a physical MFA device, which is an actual physical token. And I've got a little dollar sign there because they do cost money, whereas Google Authenticator is completely free. Now, the physical tokens can be purchased from third parties. So when you go into the console, if you choose the option to actually use a physical token, you can see it there. You can see an option to click and purchase, but it will take you off to another website like Amazon.com. So remember that for the exam. The physical tokens come from third parties. So that's the theory. And in the next lesson, we're going to secure our account by enabling multi-factor authentication.